welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. See what that says? I'm reduced. I'm 40 goods. you don't think... Firstly, I mean, you don't... Let me just put that on the side of you out of the way. You don't think that I would pay the full money for stuff like this? And, no, firstly, there's no way that a company like this would send their wares to me because they know I'll go, what's going on? You never get the crap companies sending their stuff to you. They never, ever do. You know that. Just me, I've got a burp. God, blimey, excuse me. But I still believe in bringing both the good stuff and the bad stuff to you, so you get a little bit of a contrast and a juxtaposition of the difference. So let's see what I got. It's the green one. It's lovely, isn't it?
Brewed since 1847, Carlsberg.
But I ain't gonna read all that. 3.8 ABV, blah blah blah, this, that and the other. Read it. Why am I going so slow? You can pause this, you know that. There we go. Go on, get hold of that. All in HD and everything else. Dolby stereo and God knows what. Now, let's see how we go. Always pleasant sound, the crack of, for some reason, the crack of a can. I always think that's a pleasant sound. Oh my life. One of them kind of refined pure white heads. Like a lace on a red wedding dress. But a lace on a wedding dress of an ugly woman. Now that's not nice, is it? Now, but you know when you kind of look and you go, that's nice, but, you know, I'm not expecting much underneath, you know. Yeah. Oh, that's getting a massive head. I can't avoid that. Fire hydrant type of head. Oh, my life. Well, I've tried. You know what I'm like for heads, and I don't... What's that? Is that got a widget in there? No, it ain't. Oh, it's just me rings knocking against it. Let's get me a bit of paper. Sorry, it's got writing and stuff on it, but the other side said loads of writing. So, anyway, what colour am I getting? Oh, lovely. It would pass as a sample anyway. Look, Listen, as much as I joke about it, I am going to give this every kind of... every fairness I can. In actual fact, I had the Carlsberg, the 1847 one, whatever it was, and it wasn't that bad. I kind of hated myself and felt abused, but it wasn't that bad. So, who knows? You know, I might start becoming a Popsy McLager man and leave yous all on your own. There we go. There it is. It's kind of a... Yeah, sort of a... You could call it golden, or you could call it pissy. Anyway, let's give it a sniff. Cool. It's not skunky, but it smells... It smells like damp. It smells... You know when you go... when you get... You know when you've kind of been... training or something like it, and you come home and you've forgot to get your gear out and put it in the washing and everything, and you've left it in your sports bag, and you open it up and you get that damp smell after a few days. It's got that in it. It's kind of like damp clothing, a bit of kind of wet straw. It's not a pleasant smell at all. In no way is that a pleasant smell. I'll see if I can get past him and see if I can pick anything else up. Let's get my finger over there a minute. Oh, Christ, that's worse. I can see why I left these sort of things alone when I was, like, 16 or something. I didn't drink when I was 16. But, but by the way, talking about 16, I've gone off the point here a little bit. But I found these. Look. I ain't touched these since God knows how long. I found them hiding up in the loft and that. And just had a move and everything else. So I found them up there. And I'm going to start brewing again after all these years. I used to brew wines galore. All sorts of different wines. You name it, I used to brew it. But was never... was always a complete bum with the... when it comes to brewing beers. I absolutely ruined beers and that. I seem to have a good knack of ruining all sorts of beers. So I'm going to have another try. So guys, if you've got any kind of advice, let me know. You know, I don't always take everyone's advice completely, you know, but what I do, I take it all on board. As much advice as possible, I'll take everything on board, put all the best bits together and everything, and then go, right, let's try it that way. Anyway, back to the drink. Back to this. Right. Oh, I've got to taste this now. I don't want to do it. Let's show you why I'm putting myself off. There's the bubbles. They're kind of getting climbing through there. I've got to go in, I suppose. Anyway, should I say cheers with it? Cheers, go on. You might be drinking one with me. You might like it. Oh. Now, it's Popsy McLager. That's the description, full stop. But I've got to go on with this. It's... Oh, Christ. You can taste tin. You can taste tin. I mean, they do line these cans and things like that, but it tastes of tin. Even though these, as I say, they're lined, these cans, with some sort of plastic or something. But it tastes of tin. Pardon me. It's gassy. It's as nondescript a lager as you can kind of get. There's no flavours going on. There's no kind of... There's a slight maltiness, a very slight maltiness. Anything on the hops? A slight general bitterness that I couldn't put a finger on what hop there is in there. Because it's most probably just a general hop oil or something, or some sort of lupulus oil or something. Christ, it's actually quite horrible. And keep going. Go on. Listen, I'm doing this for yous guys out there, you know that. I'm not doing that for my pleasure. I hope you're grateful. I hope I get a Christmas present off of yours. Or at least a Christmas card or something. Merry Christmas or something like that. Oh, that is really actually quite... It's got an awful aftertaste. Hey, do you know, I'll tell you what reviewing a beer like this does. I'll tell you what it does. It really, really kind of, it's like a, you got, you know, imagine that you're, you know, the donkey and the carrot and all that. Well, imagine you kind of, you know, you got something nice. I don't know about a carrot, more like a pork chop or something, or, you know, a bit of chicken leg or something like that. And you're like, yeah, I'll have some of that. And you start to lag a little bit. Sometimes when you're reviewing beers, you don't lag a little bit, but you kind of, you sort of go like, all right, we'll give it a little bit of a break for a while or something like that. But then you get something like this, and it jabs you on. It's like, come on. Tell people what this is all about. You know, tell as many people as you can what that is. Just what it is. And show them the difference between that and a good beer. And that's what that has done. It's kind of goaded me on. Come on, show them what it is, you know. Sorry to get aggressive in that, but show them, show people what that, the difference between that and something like a Gold Lager or something like that is so massive, and yet the difference in price isn't that much. Even at the reduced price of, what was it, £2.79 for four of them? Big reduction in price, usually it was something like a pound each or something. Anyway, bottoms up, chin chin and all that. It's wet cardboard. It's yuck. It's really yuck. It's like something's been drained through wet cardboard. In actual fact, that's nasty. The other four, I'm going to make shandy up or something like that. I ain't going to waste it. I'll make shandy up and the girls will have some shandy. They like a bit of shandy. I'll give them some shandy. They'll probably go, what's wrong with this shandy? It tastes horrible. Anyway, chin chin. Don't buy it. Don't buy it. Don't. Whatever price it is, treat yourself. Go up market. Even if it's just for Christmas. Bye.